1절부터 11절까지
verses 1 through 11 we'll have responsive reading.
요한복음 2장 1절에서 11절입니다.
It's John 2, 1 through 11.
제가 먼저 1절 읽겠습니다. 사흘째 되던 날 갈릴리 가나에 혼례가 있어 예수의 어머니도 거기 계시고
Jesus also invited to the wedding with his disciples.
포도주가 떨어진지라 예수의 어머니가 예수에게 이르되 저들에게 포도주가 없다 하니
And Jesus said to her, Woman, what does this have to do with me? My hour has not yet come.
그의 어머니가 하인들에게 이르되 너희에게 무슨 말씀을 하시든지 그대로 하라 하니라
Now there were six stone water jars there for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding 20 or 30 gallons.
항아리 물을 채우라 하신즉 아귀까지 채우니
And he said to them, Now draw some out and take it to the master of the feast. So they took it.
된 포도주를 맛보고도 어디서 났는지 알지 못하되 물도 온 하인들은 알더라. 연회장이 신랑을 불러
And said to him, Everyone serves the good wine first, and when people have drunk freely, then the poor wine, but you have kept the good wine until now. This, the first of his sign, Jesus did at Cana in Galilee, and manifested his glory, and his disciples believed in him. Amen. Let us bless each other, be at peace. You're the missionaries to save the world.
그 항만 땅을 기업으로 상속하십시다.
Receive the inheritance of the desolate heritages.
오직 예수만 바라보고 예수만 드러나는 삶이 되기를 바랍니다.
I really hope that your lives become the life where you only reveal Jesus Christ.
멈추지 않고 우리의 생명 다하기까지 오직 예수 그리스도 그분만 외치는 우리 하나교회 모든 성도들 되기를 주의 이름으로 축원합니다.
I bless you in the name of the Lord and may all of our Hana Church believers become the people who really present Jesus Christ inside of your life.
알고 누리는 성도 누리는 인생입니다.
It is today's title is a life truly knowing
Christ를 바로 알고
and enjoys Christ.
인생입니다.
It is a life that truly knows and enjoys Christ.
신자든 불신자든
believer or a non-believer, all of their fundamental problems has started off from the same place.
믿지 않는 불신자의 문제는 무엇입니까?
Then what is the problem of those who do not believe, the non-believers?
모든 문제를 해결하신 예수 그리스도를 모르는 데서 안 당해도 될 문제를 당하고 살아가는 것이고요.
These people are faced with the problems that they don't even have to face because they do not know Jesus Christ.
종교를 의지하고
And they rely on religion. And they're comforted by talismans and fortune telling. And they're living on their lives with that strength. And one day, without them knowing, their lives become a Tower of Babel where it has no choice but to crumble down. But Jesus Christ has finished all of these problems.
고통 속에서 모든 불신자
But because they do not know Christ who has solved all these problems, that is why they're in midst of the same problems and they're faced with the same suffering over and over. Then what about the believers? They have received all of the solutions. But because they do not know the gospel that they must know and truly enjoy, that is why they're living a worse off life than the non-believers.
그나마 불신자들은 어떤 면에서 보면은 돈도 벌고
If you see the non-believers, in one sense, they're making money and they enjoy the world.
나름대로 사는 맛을 가지고 살아가는 것을
And they have a point of living and they're living on their lives that way.
물론 그들의 근본은 지옥 배경이기 때문에
But their fundamentals is the background of hell. Yes, they will live a life like hell and they will end up in hell later on.
근데 나름대로 불신자는 열심히 살아가면서
But the non-believers they really live a diligent life.
그 맛을 가지고 살아가는 사람들이 많이 있습니다.
And they're enjoying the world and they're making money and they're living their lives that way.
근데 성도는
But the believers, because they have lost hold of the gospel that God has given them, they try to live a kind life, a diligent life, and they try to place all of their efforts. But you're able to see the believers, they're always suffering as they live on. So when you talk with the believers, if I ask, can you go to heaven if you die right now? And there are many believers that say, oh, how would I know? I have to die to know. So the believer or the non-believers, their fundamentals are the same. For the non-believers, they do not know Christ, the gospel. That is why they are suffering. But for the believers, they have received the gospel and they have received salvation, but they're not able to enjoy that. That is why they're living the same way as the non-believers. So if there's something that is most important to us, it is knowing the gospel and enjoying it. And there, all the things are solved. God has given us the gospel as the solution to everything, so that is why we must know the gospel and enjoy it. As I was able to open up my eyes a little bit to see the gospel, when I was looking towards the problems, I was able to think. As I was looking towards the people who are faced with problems and hardships, I was sorry for them. With the gospel alone, it is enough and it's everything. But because people are not able to enjoy this, they're facing problems, and I feel sorry for them. I really bless you in the name of the Lord. May you truly go inside of Christ, who has given us all of the solutions. Then first, how must our belief, our walk of faith, start off? So first, we must take a look at how the Bible and what God tells us who Jesus is. First, people just think of Jesus as one of the renowned person. And even if you see the people who go up against Jesus, Jesus lived a renowned life. And there are many people who think that, oh, he was a person who lived for others and he sacrificed himself for others. And most of the people believe Jesus in that manner. That is why people ask of people who believe in Jesus to live a kind life. But you must not be falling into misconception. Church is not a place where we make kind people or moral people. If you truly know the gospel, and when we enjoy the gospel, then we become kind and we become moral. There are many people who do not walk the walk of faith but want to send their children to the church. Why is that the case? It is because when they view church, there are many kind people and there are moral people. That is why they want to send their children to church. And that's how people think of Jesus. Then the Bible and God, what does He tell us who Jesus is? If you see in John 1. It tells us Jesus is the God whom we are able to see.
보이지 않는 하나님이신데 자신을 보이는
God is a God who we are not able to see, but He presented Himself to us, and that is shown in John 1:14. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen His glory. And if you see in John 1:1, we are able to know that Jesus is God. And if you see in John 1:2-3, you're able to see He was there from the beginning. And everything was made through His words. And it is Christ who is God that has come to set us free from sin, curses, and the authority of Satan, and make us the children of God. And that is why if you see in John 1:12, whoever believes in His name has given the right to become the children of God. What does it mean to become the children of God? It means that He has set us free from sin, curses, and the authority of Satan. And it is the God who came to us to do that work, and that is Jesus. And inside of Jesus, there is true life. And that is why those whoever accepts the life of God comes upon them. If you see in John 1:4, in Him was life, and the life was the light of men. And if you see in verse 9, it tells us, the true light which gives light to everyone was coming into the world. Jesus Christ has come to us as life, and He has come as the light to shine all of the world. Our flesh grow weaker as time goes on. But the life of soul, this is the true life. Inside of Christ, we are able to grow new every day. We all know that inside of our flesh there is soul. And the soul that is inside of the flesh, when the soul leaves, we call that death.
가장 중요한 것이 있다면은 육체의 생명도 중요하지만 그 속에 담겨진
Then what is really important to us, it is that our flesh is also important, but what is inside of our soul is the most important. So when does the life of the soul come to life? That is when we accept Jesus Christ who has come as life. That's when it comes restored. And that is what we call eternal life. So who is Jesus? He is a person who is full. And if you see in verse 14 in chapter 1, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen His glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth. So inside of Jesus, there is the full of grace and truth. And it also tells us in verse 16, for from His fullness we have all received grace upon grace. Those who have accepted Christ, the life of God dwells among them. Then how do we know Jesus as? Who is the Jesus that I believe? We must have the answer. And that is when our lives, our businesses, our walk of faith become successful.
If you 어떤 면에서 가장 불쌍한 자로 이 땅에 살아가게 되는 것입니다.
Though we might walk the walk of faith, but if you do not believe or know Jesus as according to the word of God, then we just become a person who is in a poor situation. But when we are able to know that the covenant that is given to us, that Jesus is Christ and Jesus Christ has come as the true light, then our thoughts become different. So according to our thoughts, answers begin. So the Israelites came out of Egypt. They came out of Egypt by the power of God. How happy must have they been? So they were enslaved for 430 years and they were now set free. But even that happiness was just a meanwhile. Now they're faced with the Red Sea. And the army of Egypt, they're chasing after the Israelites. And now they're faced with this dilemma. So what is the correct thought here? The Israelites were lamenting that they're gonna die. And they were lamenting and resenting towards the leader, Moses. And that is why Moses tells, and say, you guys stand still and see the salvation that God has prepared for us. The Egyptians that you have seen today, you will no longer see. So think. So what is correct? Is standing still correct, or resenting and lamenting like the Israelites and asking for methods correct? If Jesus is not the Christ, then yes, we do have to cry out like the Israelites. But if God is truly alive, and if Jesus is the Christ, then whose words are correct? Whose words are correct? The words of Moses is correct.
And
so if you see in the book of Numbers, chapter 14, you're able to see the 10 spies. The report of the 10 spies and the report of Joshua and Caleb were different. Joshua and Caleb, they spied in the land of Canaan with the eyes that God is with them. But the 10 spies, they have lost hold of the fact that God was with them. So are my thoughts connected with the thoughts of God or not? That is where all of our thoughts and the answers begin. You're able to see Paul, he was faced with a storm. He on purpose got on the boat as a criminal so that he can meet the Caesar. And there were many people that was with him. And there was the captain of the ship who knew the road so very well. And there was the commander as well. But their experiences, money or authority was of no help when they were faced with the storm. And that is why they threw off all of the all of the things that were loaded on the boat.
시달리면서 구원의 유망이 없었더라.
And for 14 days and night, they were
다 끝났다라고 생을 포기하는 그런
And they were giving up on their lives.
근데 거기에 오히려 제수의 신분인 바울이 있었습니다.
But there was Paul who was in the situation as a criminal. He was in a He was in midst of them and stood before them and said, Now, take heart, and there will be no loss of life among you. And the angel of the Lord stood before me and said, Paul, do not fear, you must stand before Caesar. And has given all of the life into your hands. And Paul said, I believe that these words that was proclaimed will be fulfilled. And that is what Paul confesses. And all of the criminals that heard the words of Paul were at peace. So, which is correct. If God is alive, then what kind of thoughts are correct? So holding on to your life, truly think. As we live our lives, there are many relationships, and because we are faced with the dilemma or conflicts between those relationships, we fall into discouragement. And there are many people who try to give up on their walk of faith as well. When you meet people who inside of the field, and they, most of them have lived a walk of faith and went to church, but because they were faced with a relationship problem, they leave church.
인생의 여러 가지 어려움과 환경과 또 질병과 구조적인 문제와 큰 사고를 당하는 문제들도 있을 수 있습니다.
And there at times will be problems like Paul where we're faced with a life problem where we cannot solve. And at that time, what kind of thoughts we have is important. And the same as we work, we can have many thoughts, but we must know that what kind of standard with what standard we have that thought. You must take a look at, am I standing before this problem with the thoughts that of that God is with me and Jesus is the Christ? We too, when we say that we believe, but when we're faced with an incident or a problem or difficulty, we go back to our old self. If God is alive and Jesus Christ is the solution to all the problems and He is the true Christ and that I am the children of God, then we must start our thoughts off with that. If that's not the case, we could live whatever we want. Right now, God is still holding on to us. You must remember that. Joseph was sold off as a slave by his brothers. When other people view Joseph, he's a slave, but Joseph himself didn't think of himself as a slave. And he thought to himself that God to fulfill the dream that God has given him, God has sent him to Egypt. So, whatever we think, it is the start of our answer.
어떤 생각과 어떤 말을 하느냐 따라서 하나님의 응답은 시작되게.
What kind of thoughts we have and what kind of word of God that we hold on to, it is the start of the answer. Do you know the characteristics of those who fail in life? They never had the thought that God is alive, and Jesus is the solution to all of the problems, and He's the Christ, and that I am a children of God. That is why they have no choice but to fail. We must always know that inside of our lives, God is alive, and Jesus is the Christ, and through Jesus Christ, I am the child of God. And that is when all of our thoughts turn to answers. So it is telling us what we must confirm first. Our thoughts are the start of the answer. Then where does the correct thoughts start off from? It is that God is with me, and through Christ, He has made me His child, and that God is, and Jesus is the solution to all of the problems. And I believe, I bless you in the name of the Lord that you may really enjoy this. Then second, you must really enjoy Christ in all of our situation. So in today's passage, we all know this passage so very well. So this wedding was faced with a difficulty. But for even from here, there are many people who thought differently. Because of those thoughts, people moved. And later on, they were able to see the sign of God. So during a wedding, everything must be abundant and full. But if you see here, they ran out of wine. So in the wedding, they have to have wine. And there was even this kind of word. The husband might not appear, but the wine must not run out. And if the wine runs out, then the one who ran the wedding is very embarrassed. But if you see in verse 3, they ran out of wine. So what was truly needed, they ran out. But isn't that the case for our lives? When we need it the most, we don't have. And when we need it the most, we are lacking. Isn't that our life? We enjoy everything of the things of the world, but our hearts are empty. Many people, they think that they can fill their emptiness with other things. But it can't. And that is when the mother of Jesus said to Jesus, they have no wine. So what was the reason that Maria, the mother of Jesus, said these words? And this is when Jesus said to her, woman, what does this have to do with me? What does this mean? Does it have a meaning of rejecting or meaning of accepting? In one sense, it is a word of rejecting. So he says woman to his mother because that was a place of the authority of Christ. So it might seem as if he doesn't want to
나는 사람들이 필요로 하는 그 요구를 들어주기 위해서 온 것이 아니다라는 거.
He's just rejecting his mother. Jesus is saying that I'm not here to give them what they want.
그리스도로서 근본의 문제를 해결하기 위해서 왔다는 사실의 의미를 담고 있는 것이 여자여 나와 무슨 상관이 있나이까?
As of Christ, he is here to solve the fundamental problems, and this meaning is inside of a woman. What does this have to do with me? And that is when Maria goes to the servants and says, "Do whatever he tells you."
예수님이 하인들에게 말했습니다.
And then Jesus told the servants,
"항아리에 물을 채워라."
He says, "Fill this jar with water."
연회장에게 갖다 주라.
And now, draw some out and take it to the master of the feast.
물을 채우고 그 물을 채운 그 항아리에서 하인들이 물을 떠서 연회장에 갖다 줍니다.
And now the servants did as they were told.
그 항아리에 포도주를 부은 게 아닙니다.
They didn't pour wine inside of that jar. They poured water, and the servants know so very well because they were the ones that filled that jar with water. But if that water was truly water, then we're just feeding that person water.
하인들이 자기들이 물 갖다 부어놓고 지금 포도주로 어떤 피로난 현장에 그 물을 갖다 줍니다.
Now they are taking the water to a place where they need wine.
근데 그 연회장에서 그 맛을 보는 순간에 사람 봐도 놀랍니다.
Now the master of the feast, everybody whoever drank it were
이렇게 좋은 포도주를 어떻게 계속 내놓느냐 놀라게 되는 것이죠.
Were shocked and said, "How can you give us this good wine until the end of the feast?" And that is told in today's passage.
마리아가 예수님께 찾아가서 포도주가 없다라고 있는 실상을 그대로 알린 것입니다.
So at first, Maria goes to Jesus and tells him what the situation was like as is. So here it tells us how we must pray. It means that we just have to take all of the things as is and go before God. There's no need us to design it or make it seem like a good thing. We just have to take our prayer as is and before God. If that is an incorrect prayer topic, then God will change it and answer it.
말고 빼지도 말고 그대로 하나님께 가지고 나가는 이것이 바로 기도인 것이.
So don't add things to it or don't even take out things. Just go before God as is.
나와 무슨 상관이 있나이까 그런 말을 들었죠.
So at first, Jesus said to Maria and woman, "What does this have to do with me?" So this is a very embarrassing word. But what does Jesus say? Or what does Maria say? He says, "Do whatever he tells you."
하나님이 우리에게 무슨 말씀을 하시든지 그대로 할 마음이 있다면은.
If you have the heart to do whatever, the things that God tells us to do, then it is enough.
오늘 무슨 말씀을 하시든지 내 마음에 그 마음대로 할 생각만 있다면은 지금 또 하나님은.
Whatever God tells me to do right now, if we have the heart to do it, then God will be at work.
직접 물을 갖다 붓고 또 채우고 또 뜯어 주고 했으니까요. 하인들의 생각 어떠했겠습니까?
So what were the thoughts of the servants? They were the ones that filled the jar with water and served it.
예수님 가셨을 때 성령으로 와가지고 잉태된 예수님에 대한 부분을 이야기를 들었었어요.
And Maria knows that Jesus was Jesus came to her in the Holy Spirit. So the thoughts of Maria regarding Jesus and the thoughts of the servants, it was different. If you know who Jesus is, then all of our thoughts and all of our actions come from that.
여기서 우리에게 중요한 부분들 말씀하고 있습니다.
And from here it tells us something very important.
말씀하시는 중요한 메시지의 핵심이 무엇입니까?
So what is the core of the
오늘 우리의 인생을
this wedding?
번에 바꿀 수 있다라는 사실을 말씀하고 있는 거예요.
It is telling us that God can change our life in an instant.
인생의 문제만 해결될 뿐만 아니라 인생의 근본 자체가
바꾸어지게 되는 것입니다.
If you accept Jesus is the Christ inside of our hearts, then our lives will change instantly, and He will change our fundamentals. So it tells us in John 5:24, "Truly, truly, I say to you, whoever hears my words and believes in Him who sent me has eternal life. He does not come into judgment, but has passed from death to life." If you truly know who Jesus Christ is, then our fundamentals, our life fundamentals, will change.
사람은 바꿀 수 없는 존재인데 예수 그리스도를 바로 알고 그 그리스도가 영접되어지고
Mankind are not a being that we're able to change. But when we accept that Jesus is the Christ, then our fundamentals change.
우리 포도주 되었다. 어떻게 생각하십니까?
How do you think water changed to wine?
겉으로만 변화된 것이 아니죠.
It didn't just change in the outer appearance.
심적인 변화를 가져온 것입니다.
It also brought a change to the texture.
시간 가면 갈수록 우리는 완전히 바뀌어진 인생으로서 가치 있는 삶으로 누려지게
And the quality. So when we enjoy that Jesus is the Christ inside of our life every day, then our lives will also change. What can change our life?
냉정하게 한번 생각해 보십시오.
Really think about this.
사람들이 마음 먹기 따라서 다르다라고 합니다.
So many people say it's according to our heart. Did our lives not change because we didn't set our heart? That's not it. And many people say that they just need money. If you have money, then our lives will take place. But that is not the case. People have a lot of money, but when they're faced with a spiritual problem, their failures come to them. Why are many other young people commit suicide? Our nation is in the first place of suicide. Many people commit suicide and they listen to the news about suicide and they commit suicide. Why is that the case? It's because their fundamentals has not changed. When does it change? It is when Jesus Christ comes to our heart. That is when our fundamentals change and my life's change and all of my problems change. If you truly know that Jesus is the Christ, and when we follow after the word, just as how God changed the water to wine, God will change our life. I'll come to the end of my words. Can signs be shown even today? If we know who Jesus Christ is accurately, then that change will occur even today. So what is the interest and the will of God? God wants us to know who Jesus Christ is. The world we can know later on. If you do not know Jesus Christ accurately, then we do not know the world accurately.
하나님께서 원하시는 관심과 소원은 저와 여러분이 복음을 제대로 알기를
The interest and the will of God is for us to know the gospel accurately. God has given us everything, and that is the gospel. And those who know the gospel and enjoy the gospel, then they will come to life. Even their thoughts will come to life.
행동과 말들도 살리는 행동과 말들로
And even our actions and our words will come out to save.
바울이 로마 교회 편지를 보냈습니다.
Paul sends the letter to the Roman church. In Romans 1:9 it says they want
그래서 내가 쉬지 않고 너희를 위해서 기도한다 했어요.
So he is praying unceasingly for them.
이미 복음이 증거된 로마 교회입니다.
It was the Roman church that was already proclaimed the gospel. But why did Paul send this letter? In verse 15, Romans 1:15, it tells us,
있는 대로 로마에 있는 너에게 복음 전하기를 원한다 했어.
It says, so I am eager to preach the gospel to you also who are in Rome.
근데 바울이 왜 그 로마 교회 다시 가기를 원했는가?
Why did Paul want to go to Rome again? Because this is a gospel that they have to hear again. That is why it tells us in Romans 1:16. This gospel is power. It is the power of God for salvation to everyone who believes. So day by day we must hear the gospel and go before the gospel. Yes, you can say, oh, I've heard the gospel till now.
로마 교회 복음을 들었습니다. 그런데 또다시 바울이 내가 너에게 나아갈 좋은 길을 기를 원하는데
The Roman Church, they heard the gospel, but Paul tells them that so that they, he is eager to preach the gospel, he wants to go to Rome again. Other people could say that, oh, do you truly know the gospel?
그 복음을 알고 누리기를 원한다. 그래서 너희가 복음 앞에 나오기를 원한다라고 하나님 오늘 우리에게 요청하고 있는 것입니다.
Or God is asking us, do you know the gospel? If you truly want to know the gospel and enjoy the gospel, you must come before me. Those who think lightly of the gospel, they are not able to receive salvation. If you see in 1 Corinthians 1:18, it says, For the word of the cross is folly to those who are perishing. But to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. The non-believers need the gospel, but for us, we also need the gospel. We heard the gospel and received salvation. And to go out as the evangelist to save the 237 nations and the 5,000 tribes, we need this gospel. This blessed answer and the grace be upon you to really know the gospel and enjoy.
찬송 내 구주 예수를 더욱 사랑 314장 찬송하면서 기도하기를 원합니다. 기도 제목들 한번 보십시다. 그리스도 비밀을 바로 알고 누리는 인생 비밀 가진 자의 전도 제자의 기도입니다. 같이 한번 읽어보십시다. 모든 것은 해답으로 주신 그리스도 복음 속으로 들어가게 하옵소서. 모든 것은 아니고 모든 것을 해답으로 주신 그리스도 복음 속으로 들어가게 하옵소서. 두 번째입니다. 현장의 요구를 채우는 것이 아닌 인생의 근본이 바뀌는 복음 누리게 하옵소서. 세 번째입니다.